jail. The prison band was there, they began to wail. The band was jumping and the joint began to swing. You should have heard this knocked out jailbird sing. Let it rock, everybody, let it rock. Everybody in home say a clock.
Wow, we're here. We're really gonna do this, aren't we?
Well, you bet we are. We just flew 2,500 miles. We're not turning back now. I mean, you still want to, right?
Are you kidding me?
I hate what they did to you. Oh. Hi. Sorry.
We are here to get married. I don't think she speaks English.
Oh, so you want to get married? $200 and go up into the thousands. Let's start there. How much do you want to spend?
$2,000.
There's a dressing room in the back. You just help yourself.
Okay. We're getting married! Why?
Oh, they're getting married next Saturday.
Aha.
What does that mean?
It's an expression. It denotes a sudden revelation.
I know what aha means, but what's the sudden revelation?
Well, Ed and Jenny are getting married. But you want to get married first to prove to them that you don't care that they're getting married. But the very fact that you flew thousands of miles to prove that you don't care that they're getting married says very loudly that you do. Well, I give you an address, you give it to them, and they watch.
Well, where's the camera?
Right here.
Good. Let's go ahead and do this thing.
Look what I found back there. Oh, they had a whole bag of them. Some had big old hoops and parasols, slinky bags, puffy sleeves. Oh, I just about went crazy trying to pick one. They had a lot of tuxedos back there, too.
So I see that you found our rental area.
Once we are married, everything is going to work out just fine. I'm sure of it. He is going to forget all about Jenny, and he is going to fall in love with me.
You want to know what I've learned after one husband, four marriages, and 17 years in this business? Any sentence that starts with "once we're married" is a train bound for heartache.
What?
Oh, you look wonderful.
So, I hope Jenny's watching right now. Let's get this show on the road. Is your minister back yet?
Well, yeah, not yet.
Hey, Sandy, sorry to interrupt. I just couldn't help but notice Ken is out in the parking lot. He's sick again, if you know what I mean.
Yes, I know what you mean.
Well, I put him in the back seat of your car to sleep it off.
Thank you, again.
Ladies and gentlemen, live from Las Vegas, it's showtime! Welcome to the wedding of two wonderful kids in love.
Stan and Beth.
Stan, bring the little lady up here and let's celebrate your special day and your special union, Elvis style. Oh, well, my hands are shaking and my feet. I can't seem to stand on my own two feet. What do you do when you have such luck? I'm in love. I'm all shook up. Ooh, ooh, hey.
Your wife, will you love? Is that your phone?
I'm sorry. It might be important.
You're not going to get that, are you?
I have to agree with the little lady here, Stan. If you take that, you're not nothing but a hound dog. You're nothing but a hound dog.
She's watching. She says, stop. Don't do it. Don't get married.
How dare she? She runs our happiness once, and that wasn't enough? She wants to run it again? Jenny? Once wasn't enough? You want to take my happiness away the second time? Well, bring it over!
Give me that up!
The river of love winds a mighty crooked course.
I tried to tell her where that train goes.
I'm sorry, Beth, but I don't love you. I love Jen. I've always loved Jen. Baby, I'm coming home tonight. I'm taking the first plane out. I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you.
Stan, don't be cruel. It's true.
How long will that take?
The hurting part, I don't know, but you meet new people all the time. Hi, I'm John.
I'm Beth.
Oh, dear.
Well, good morning.
Good morning.
Are you part of the Wells Cannon family?
No, ma'am. I'm here about the minister's job. We talked on the phone last night. I'm Lou DeGeorge. How do you do? Here, listen. For I can't help falling in love with...
That was terrible.
Well, it's early. I'm not warmed up. I'm not wearing sideburns in my costume. I'm.
You're at least 70 years old.
What? So that disqualifies me?
Now that is through.
We have arrived.
You may take our things.
Oh, man. Oh, my.
I'll just put them over here, if that's okay.
Now, you must be the two stars that are coming in to get me.
Vanessa Wells.
And Bryce Cannon.
Of course.
And hey, pitchers, I would know.
We do not make pitchers.
We make films.
We make art.
We make movies if you must, but we do not make
pictures.
Okay.
Oh, sorry.
Well, we were in a television series together many, many years ago when we were much younger. It was hugely successful. I imagine even you might have heard of it. We played a pair of newlywed spies who, for some reason, did the majority of their espionage on surfboards.
The Surfing Secret Agents. Yeah, I remember you.
Your outfit is just lovely.
Of course it is.
Yes, Monty, baby, it's Bryce. Look, we're down here at the chapel and, well, where are the reporters? No, not one. Well, did you tell them the right place?
The world couldn't get enough of us.
Agent 76.
Agent 44.
Do you remember when we used to find our fans hiding in our dressing room closets?
What?
Wrinkles. No, not in your face. In your dress. Isn't that linen?
Oh my, thank you, Bryce. Momentary lapse. I'll just take it off until the press arrives.
You know, I think I shall do the same. We learned this on set, you know. Never sit in your costume. Not
I am flawless. There's not an extra pound on me anywhere. Yes, yes, I do have a little crow's feet, but it's barely noticeable. And yes, some gray around the temples, but do you know that's considered sexy in a man? All and all, I am fabulous.
Washed up old celebrities, and I quote,
we're not old! Everybody knows I'm gay!
I kind of suspected. Oh, but only because you're so pretty.
Well, I had no idea you're so tall!
Fame here. Fame of the highest order. We had it once, and we'll have it again.
Yes, we will.
The only question is, how are we going to get it?
Okay.
We'll just have to think of something else.
Well, there's always the other thing.
Oh God, not that.
Well, maybe we've gotten to the point where we must consider it.
Consider what?
The Surfing Secret Agents Reunion Special, 30 years later.
Nothing says you're washed up like a reunion special.
And clear away all the fans so that we can pass.
Huh?
Oh, Herbert, go clear the fans.
But there's nobody.
Look out, world, we're coming back.
Vanessa Wells.
And Bryce Cannon.
No.
I tell you, there was nobody out there.
I know.
Quite a pair, huh?
Oh, this was outside your door. I couldn't help but notice that there were no directions from the sender authorizing that it could be left in an unprotected space. And unless you filed a written order to that effect, well, your mail carrier has committed a gross violation of postal code.
Oh my.
Yes, it's best not to let conduct like this go. I would recommend speaking to your mail carrier about the matter. And if you're not satisfied, talk to your local postmaster.
Well, aren't you official? Thank you. Was there something else?
Yes. I'm Marvin Marvel. I'm getting married today.
The Midwestern Fiona.
Oh, yeah? How about you come on inside and say that you paste a paper tongue crap? My fiance will jack you up like you ain't ever been jacked before.
Oh, I guess I was just a little off.
Is someone bothering you, Angel?
Just some pervert watching me change my clothes in the car. Yeah, you better run, you yellow freaking lizard. Ugh!
Hey, baby. We all said to get married.
Yeah, I think so. You like the place?
Oh, Marvin, it is like a dream. I never thought I'd be getting married in a place so classy, with a beautiful altar and real flowers and, oh my God, white chairs. Everyone in the cell block was in on it. They helped make the wedding chapel arrangements, and they really were in on it.
Oh.
It gave us all something special to think about, you know?
Oh, that is beautiful. And Marvin, you're quite the romantic, aren't you?
According to my mother, I'm quite the lunatic.
Your brother, too.
Yes, I wish they were here to help us celebrate, but they don't get it. I told them you have to look past the exterior and see what's inside. Well, that's what Fiona and I did, and that's why we're so happy. But they don't understand. When I showed my mother a picture of Fiona, she called her a... I can't say it.
She called me a slut. And when I showed my mother a picture of Marvin, she called him a fruit.
She did?
Sorry, baby. It's just that you're so different from any man I ever went out with. In a good way.
I could take on any of your hot ex-boyfriends, even Fist if you wanted, and show them a thing or two.
Huh?
I've got moves, Fiona. You just haven't seen them in action. odd.
Marvin, what's wrong with you? Are you jealous of Fist or something?
Do you know what I would do to Fist if he were here right now? First, I'd put him in a headlock. Yeah, I know how to do that. I was on the wrestling team. Okay, so I never wrestled. I was the stopwatch guy. But I learned all the moves. So I'd put him in a headlock, and I'd spin him around and around, and I'd take him down so fast he wouldn't know what hit him. And then I'd squeeze him in the vice that is my arm until he cried for his mommy and apologized for the lousy things he did to you. That's what I'd do.
Mama.
Dude, they even knew the name of the wedding chapel. Naturally, I was none too happy.
I ain't your girl! I'd have to be a freaking idiot to be your girl!
I guess you're still mad about the bank thing?
The bank thing? I got 15 years, Fist, and you got 25!
Yeah, all right, already, so I made a mistake. At least you're kind of puny, ain't he? Fist.
Marvin!
Let go, Fist! Stop it! Let go of him!
Nice to meet you.
Baby, are you all right? You are an animal!
Hey, chapel lady, you get right back here. I don't need you calling the cops on me. Sit!
Yes, Mr. Fist.
For me. Look, no matter, all right? The point is, he's got a past.
Oh, yeah?
Yep. Did you know he was an Eagle Scout?
Yeah?
Did you know that he teaches Sunday school?
Yeah.
Did you know that he volunteers at a library?
Yeah, so what's your point?
He is gonna bore the hell out of you, Fiona. He writes a column on why zip codes is important.
I never truly appreciated that until Marvin explained it to me. How could you be so stupid?
And how could you be so cold? Not answering a guy's letters for 6 years. I called. I had hubcap ride emails and letters and nothing. You didn't even have the courtesy to tell me to go to hell if that's how you felt about it.
Fine. If that's what you want, go to hell!
I could tell. Even when she told me the bad stories about you, she missed you a lot. And Fiona, Fist didn't come here today to berate you or to marry you. He came here today to say he's sorry for everything that's happened. And then he misses you and needs you as a friend. You two matter more to each other than you know. And it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure that out. Fist is right. You two have bonds that can't be broken. And I may be crazy, but my conscience will not allow me to stand here and watch you two just throw it all away.
So you love her enough to have me in your life?
Apparently so.
What do we do, Marvin?
Las Vegas police. The chapel is surrounded. We know you're in there, Fist. Come out now when no one gets hurt.
Let's go out the back. Out minister. And unless you're a minister, this isn't going to happen.
Well, lucky for you, I am.
And what?
A minister. I took a course in the joint, got my reverend credentials.
No way!
Yeah, it's Hubcap's idea. He was doing some kind of scheme and it needed a minister to make it work, so, I mean, hell, I had the time. So what are you gonna do? Fiona, will you take this man to be your husband, to love and to comfort, to honor and to keep, and forsaking all others, try to be a good wife to him and not bust his chops quite so much as you did with me?
I will!
And you. Do you promise to take her to be your wife, to love and to comfort, to honor and to cherish, and forsaking all others? Try to protect her from all the scumbags out there and do a better job of looking out for her than I did?
I will.
You've got 2 minutes, Fist. Better come again.
All right. Yep. Okay, will you repeat your vows?
Then do it.
By the power vested in me by the state of correction, by the Department of Corrections of the state of Texas, I hereby pronounce you husband and wife. You're gonna have the rest of your life to kiss her, buddy. Good luck, baby.
This is the police. Time's up. We're coming in.
I'm coming.
I'll write to you.
You better. Marvin, kiss the bride already.
Where are my guests?
Hey.
Hey, Sandy. I'm sorry we're late.
Oh, I was starting to get worried. You look beautiful.
Oh, thank you. So do you. I love this. Where'd you get it?
Oh, there's a little shop near Fremont Street. They sell the best vintage clothing and jewelry. We ought to go sometime.
Oh, I'd love to.
It will be.
It will be.
It will be.
Hey, Sandy, we made it.
Look, who just flew in from Wilbur, Nebraska. Oh, hello. Hi, sweetie. John and Beth. This is Marvin and Fiona. I married them about, a year and a half ago?
16 months, 3 days, and 2 hours.
Is it me something?
Oh, it's nice to meet you.
And guess what else?
What?
He's here now. He came with us.
He's here?
Of course he's here. He's always here.
He's just parking the car.
Okay.
Hey, chapel lady. Oh. Congratulations. Oh. How about a hug for old Fist?
Oh, now, Fist, I think it's time you called me Sandy.
Sandy. I think sure I changed since the last time I was here. Hey, I'm a free man.
I heard.
Yeah, and do you want to know why? You want to know how come? It's because of this guy right here. He may not look like much, but this is one great guy.
We are now entering Sandy's Chapel of Love.
This is take one. Action.
Welcome, friends. Today, we'll be making plans for my upcoming wedding. Aren't weddings the most wonderful events, Bryce?
They sure are, Vanessa.
We've chosen this little chapel here in Las Vegas that specializes in celebrity weddings.
We're not having issues. Fiona and I couldn't be happier. She's an angel. We're having issues.
We are?
Yes.
Well, I didn't know that.
That's why I'm telling you.
Is this what that guy was saying about you wanting your privacy back?
Yes!
Wow. Well, that just shows you what kind of a man this is. You should be filming this guy. Even when he's pissed off, he's still a nice guy.
I just can't. Not with you, John.
Bev, is that what this is all about? Oh, my goodness. I've waited for years to meet the right woman, and now I've met her, and she's you. And yes, I really, 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 really want to marry you.
Well, in that case, yes!
It's official. I never wanted to pass up a gig as the king. Here we go. Live from Las Vegas, it's showtime. Welcome to the wedding of two wonderful kids in love, Sandy and Lou. We're going to celebrate your special day and your special union, Elvis style. Take my hand, take my whole life too, for I can't tell falling in love with you.
Now I got six words for her. Thank you very much.